Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon. Friends, today we have a topic which is EBITDA versus the net income. Well, EBITDA, one of the very important driver which many company uses for valuation purpose. What is EBITDA? See, EBITDA is basically earning before interest, tax, depreciation and amortization, and is a method that is it is often used to find the profitability of the companies and the industry. So it is very similar to the concept of the net income with a few extra non-operating additions. So EBITDA is an indicator, you know, it is used for conducting comparative analysis for various companies. It is one of the major tools that is used for evaluating firms with different sizes, structures, having taxes or depreciation. So how does EBITDA has been calculated? EBITDA is equal to EBIT plus depreciation plus amortization. That's it. It can be also be calculated as EBITDA is equal to net profit plus taxes plus interest plus depreciation and plus amortization. So if you have net profit, then you can calculate by this method. If you have EBIT, then you can calculate by this method. EBIT is basically your operating profit. So in operating profit, you will add back the non-cash expenditure, which is your depreciation and amortization. To simply put, depreciation is the reduction in the value of the tangible assets over time, and that results in the wear and tear of the tangible assets. And amortization, on the other hand, is the financial technique that has been used to incrementally reduce the value of the intangible assets over time. So net income is often used to find out the total earnings and the, you can say, the earnings and the, or the, you can say, the profit of the company. And it can be calculated by, you know, subtracting the cost of doing the business for that particular company's revenue. Then we have the net income, which is equal to your revenue less the cost of doing the business. Right. So cost of doing the business includes all the taxes, interest that the company should pay. So the depreciation of the assets and all the other expenses. Net income, you know, is the company's income after taking into account all the deductions and, you know, sort of taxes into account. So EBITDA is somewhat similar to net income, as both of their values are subject to change because, you know, some of the elements involved in the calculation might be subjected to sort of a thing called manipulations by the company. So let's understand this with the help of the infographics, the difference. Well, EBITDA versus net income, let's understand the definition. EBITDA is basically an indicator used for calculating the company's profit making ability, while net income indicates which is it is an indicator which is used to calculate the company's total earnings. So here the profit to calculate the profit making ability, and here the total earnings. Where exactly it is used? It is used to calculate the earning potential of the company, and it is over here it is used to calculate the earning per share, that is the EPS. So earning potential and EPS is the difference. EPS is your how much the shareholders are earning per shareholding they have. The calculation part of EBITDA, we have learned this very well. EBIT plus depreciation, that's the first method, and amortization, or we can use the net profit, but for that you need to add back taxes, interest, debt and amortization. For net income, you need to deduct from the revenue all the cost of doing the business. So it includes operating, non-operating, all the costs that are incurred will be reduced, and finally you will receive the net income. Now what exactly is the result? See, calculation of the income generated by the company without deducting any expenses like interest, taxes, debt and amortization. But over here is a total earning of the company after reducing all the expenses. Here we add back things, but here it's like the overall performance that we are talking about here. So that's the difference. Well, this was on the some of the differences that you were supposed to learn. EBITDA versus the net income. We'll understand the key differences between EBITDA and net. See, one of the key difference between the income and the EBITDA is the usage of the depreciation and amortization. EBITDA is basically an indicator which calculates the so-called profit. It calculates the profit, right? And EBITDA is an indicator. It calculates the profit of the company before paying off the expenses like debt, amortization. On the other hand, the net income is the indicator which calculates the total earnings, right, of the company, you know, after paying off its expenses, taxes and depreciation and amortization. Second, EBITDA is used as an indicator to find out the total earnings of the potential of the company. On the other hand, the net income is used to find out the earnings per share. Third, EBITDA can be measured by adding back the depreciation, amortization. If it is the case of EBIT, then, you know, or you can, if it is the case of net income, they need to add back interest, tax, debt, amortization to the profit. But in case of the net income, simply is calculated by deducting revenue with all the costs that you have. Now, with EBITDA is used to find out the earning potential of the company. So that's why, well, when investors look at the new company, they calculate EBITDA. EBITDA is also pretty easy to use, and since there's no depreciation and amortization involved. On the other hand, you know, net income is used earning per share. If the company has issued any shares, just by dividing the net income of the number of outstanding shares, we can get the EPS. Let me finally recapitulate everything. When we look at the EBITDA versus the net income, they are both the indicators that can be adjusted by the companies, but still the investors looks into the net income versus the EBITDA of these indicators for making the trading decision, to so that, you know, they can get an idea about the big picture of the company. Now, since there are these are two calculated by using the so-called income statement, the investor should use so-called ratios as well as to cross-check how the company is doing. So one or two indicator can provide enough information, but to take the decision to invest in a company based on this, on that, isn't prudent. So that's why investors should use ratios like ROIC, return on, you know, ROE, that's return on equity. You have net profit margins, then we have the gross profit margins, and so on and so forth. So along with that, the net income versus EBITDA also should look at the other financial statements, like, you know, the balance sheets, the CFS, and so on and so forth. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.